Chamba was the princely state during British's time and the capital of a kingdom which never had any successful invasion for around a millennium. Even Emperor Akbar and later Aurangzeb failed to acquire this kingdom. The founder of this lush green valley where River Ravi flows by was Raja Sahil Varman, and it was built on the request of her daughter Champavati. Chamba was named after her. Yes, this time I'll be taking you all to this small yet happy town. Let's start the trip.
Well, it was a wonderful party. Happy birthday to Shagun once again. But my time is not yet ended. It is 5:30 a.m. in morning and I am at Gaurav's home. We are going for a trip. I had already called Gaurav. I hope he must be ready. Almost ready with his luggage. Are we going for another party? Gaurav, it's 5:30 a.m. Come on. And now we are ready to go to
Chamba.
Amit bhaiya, we are coming. Gaurav, are we really going for like 5-7 days or what?
Route map is very simple. We took Yamuna Expressway and from Greater Noida we took Eastern Peripheral Expressway. And from there we took GT Karnal Road, which is now called NH44 if you search on Google Map.
So breakfast done, and not to mention that we are late.
Then we crossed Ambala, Ludhiana, Jalandhar and finally reached to Pathankot. And from there we took turn for Chamba, which is still like 130 km, and from here mountain range start.
Good morning from
Chamba.
Wow.
How's the Josh? Hi, brother.
Yesterday I had broke one of my rules that I should not drive car in nights, especially in mountains, but we have to reach to Chamba and I have to broke it. Amit bhaiya was waiting in his guest house, Lazy Mojo, and we just took our dinner and simply slept. This is our day 2 and we are going to explore
Chamba.
Chamba.
मेरे दो ही लाइन पूरे पूरे 30 सेकंड चंबा और फिर चंबा.
Today is a kind of a rainy day. Let's see how many sights we can see in
Chamba.
This is the old bus stand and also a parking area. This is how we are looking right now. How the Josh Gaurav?
Hi sir.
Perfect. So this is how we are going to explore
Chamba.
So we put on our raincoat called Pochu and roamed in a city like some alien. We both were uncomfortable, but we tried our best to record Chamba in rain.
This is called Chogan. That's the first view of Lakshmi Narayan Temple.
Just a little pause here. I hope many of you guys knows Amit Bhaiya. If not, then let me tell you that he is a doctor by profession and a wonderful photographer by heart. He gets assignments from National Geographic, Himachal Tourism, Gujarat Tourism and many more. With him, I personally feel like a carefree younger brother. Now let's come back to Chamba, which is right now soaking in rain.
We will be going to Lakshmi Narayan temple tomorrow, as I was not that much prepared for this rain. And now we are going to Chamunda temple with Amit Bhaiya. This is Amit Bhaiya's heritage property.
I was thinking that our day was wasted, but Amit Bhaiya pushed us, and frankly, we crossed the limit. Yes, in rain, we went to see Chamunda Devi Temple. Earlier, it could only be reached through some 400 steps cut out from stone pathway, but now it is easily accessible through 3 km long road from Chamba, which we of course opted in this heavy rain. It was built by Raja Umed Singh in the year 1762 and is entirely made of wood. This temple is dedicated to goddess Kali, and we witnessed Aarti here, and I was surprised few more people did came to attend it, even in this rain. Navratri is the most busiest time of the year here, when thousands of pilgrims travel from India to pay their homage to goddess. I have been to many temples, but the experience for this one in rain, when the temperature was freezingly cold, and covering it on camera was the lifetime experience. Once again, special thanks to Amit Bhaiya who took us here in this mood of climate. It was Lohri that day, kind of Punjabi and Hindu festival, which is celebrated on 13th January every year, and so we three celebrated it.
Oh boys, how's the Josh?
Hi sir!
Then made dinner for ourselves, and that's how we ended our day too. I am skipping our day 3 as we went to Khajiar, but we'll cover the same in my next video. So for now, jumping on our day 4, which was shining in sun, at least for time being. So I have shown you Chamba in rain, now see it in sun.
And this is called Chogan, the big playground of Chamba in bright sunny day.
Chamba is a small place. Most of the market revolve around Chogan. Chogan is the heart and hub center of all activity in Chamba. The famous Manjar Mela is held here. Chogan is closed for public after Dashera to April to carry out maintenance, hence we cannot go in there. So we roamed around the market, and here you can have anything. It is just any typical main bazaar of India. But yet, every place have something special to offer, and so does Chamba. There are two famous things which you can purchase from these markets. One is embroidered leather slippers for women, and simple yet designer leather slippers for men. These are all handmade. Another famous thing here is handkerchief, commonly known as Chamba Rumal. Lalita Aunty has received not one but 3 national awards for this artwork in Chamba. And you know what? She is mother of Amit Bhaiya. You can say house of creative people. Now let me take you to another big site here, Lakshmi Narayan Temple. There is a metallic image of Garuda on the high platform at the main gate of the temple. This is the main temple of this town and was built by Raja Sahil Varman in 10th century AD, who is also believed to be the founder of modern Chamba. It has the group of six temples, known for its fine classical form. Temple has been built in Shikhara style with wooden chhatris. Every place has some legends attached with it, and so does for this place as well. It is believed that the idol of Lord Vishnu at the temple has been made of a very rare marble that was brought from Vidyanchal Mountains. It is said that Raja Sahil Varman sacrificed 8 of his sons to get the marble. Finally, his eldest son, Yukkar, succeeded in acquiring the marble, and that's how the temple was made.
Now going to Sui Mata Temple. That place. That's the way for Sui Mata Temple.
We have to climb these stairs, which are roughly like 150 or 200. How's the Josh Gaurav?
Hi sir.
Cha?
Okay. Pakka hai.
Pakka hai.
Climbing stairs is not that easy for me. What about you, Gaurav?
All good? All good.
Yes, one can also reach here by road, but we prefer to climb some 10,000 stairs. Kidding.
I was thinking that was the temple, but it is not. Few more steps.
Okay. We finally reached to this small temple, which is dedicated to the queen of Raja Sahil Varman, named Sui. There is an interesting story for this temple as well. Legend says this place Chamba had no rain for years, and King Sahil Varman tried to please gods in almost all possible way. Then Brahmins advised him that he needed to sacrifice his son or wife to bring water to his kingdom. The queen could not bear the son getting sacrificed, which Raja was going to do, though with heavy heart. So she sacrificed herself first. And from that day, water started flowing in the kingdom. There has never been a shortage of it. This temple, in her remembrance, was built, and every year around March 15 to April 1, a fair is organized, which people of Chamba pay their respect to the queen who laid down her life for the welfare of her people.
That was King Palace, and now converted to a college.
It seems like we are having the last night in Chamba. So Amit Bhaiya is giving us treat.
In my Ladakh trip, I had asked Amit Bhaiya to give you one tip in photography. I hope you guys have listened to it. Now, while cooking, I am asking him to give one more tip to you guys.
Sir, love what you do and do what you love. This is my tip.
It is a day 4+1, and we are still in
Chamba. And for the quick report,
I lost my mobile.
Yes. नया फोन आएगा. Congratulations. मोबाइल को दिया.
Thank you.
जो भी लाओ दो लाना.
And as per our ritual, we are sending postcard to our home. This time from
Chamba.
We are now at Bhuri Singh Museum.
The museum is founded in year 1908 to honor Raja Bhuri Singh, and it is very close to Chogan. Entry ticket is rupees 40 for Indian and 100 for foreigner. If you want to make photos, you need to pay rupee 50 extra. Just like any other museum, it has rich collection of carved doors from old palace, frescoes, miniature paintings, sculptures, some old scriptures, paintings, royal palki and old collection of Chamba ruler coins. Because there was no invasion happened in Chamba, hence even today everything is very well preserved. Must see this place to know the history. And at last, but not the least, I would also like to show you the lovely and cozy guest house Lazy Mojo, which is situated at a place called Mangala, and it is 3 kilometers from the main city. It's a two-story building with its own parking area and have 6 double rooms like this. With neat and tidy kitchen where only organic food is cooked and most of the veggies come from their own farm. You have full access to the terrace and witness the incredible view of Chamba. I hope you liked the video. Please subscribe the channel and stay tuned. Khajiar is left. In next video, we'll take you there. Until then, have a wonderful time.
ये भी डालोगे अम्मा के पास? ये बोलते
ठीक है, हो गई ओवर एक्टिंग.
तू दिखा अपनी आगे, तू दिखा कहाँ है लाल, मेरी ज्यादा लाल है.
गौरव वेक अप, गौरव गौरव गौरव. गौरव डूइंग जॉगिंग, दैट्स ग्रेट. एंड दिस इज हाउ वी ट्रेवल. Lots and lots of luggage.